Welcome all of you in online teaching learning process. We have started paper number 1st in organic chemistry, in which we have seen unit number 4, that is chemical bonding and molecular structure with respect to molecular orbital theory. In that unit we have studied the distinction between atomic orbital and molecular orbital, along with in offline mode we have studied linear combination of atomic orbitals, that is how bonding orbitals will be formed, then how antibonding molecular orbitals will be formed, that is psi b and psi a, that is addition gives bonding and subtraction gives antibonding. Already we know that in the case of in phase combination, that is when plus and plus combines, that is in phase means addition takes place, we are getting bonding molecular orbitals. But in case of out of phase combination, plus minus combination takes place, that is we are getting antibonding molecular orbital. That is, this is a crest and this is a trough, but in this case crest overlaps with another crest, so this is a bonding and this is a antibonding. Already we have studied in offline mode, but now in online mode we will see further details regarding the what are the bonding molecular orbitals and antibonding molecular orbitals, and which are the conditions to say it is a bonding, it is antibonding. So first difference is it is formed by addition overlap of atomic orbitals, but antibonding molecular orbitals will be formed by subtraction overlap of the atomic orbitals. Then in case of bonding molecular orbital, wave functions of bonding molecular orbital is given by, that is psi b is equal to addition psi a plus psi b. But in case of antibonding, there is a subtraction. It is bonding molecular orbital, its formation takes place when the lobes of atomic orbitals have same sign, that is both the lobes are having same signs, that is crest or trough. Its formation takes place when the lobes of atomic orbitals have different signs, crest and trough, like this. The energy of bonding molecular orbital is lower than that of atomic orbitals from which it is formed, but energy of antibonding molecular orbital is higher than that of the atomic orbitals from which it is formed. The electron density is high in the region between the nuclei of bonded atoms, but electron density is nearly zero, nil, in the region between the nuclei of bonded atoms. Every electron in bonding molecular orbital contribute towards the attractive forces, but every electron in antibonding molecular orbital forms repulsive forces. And one most important difference is the overlap integral, which is represented by S, is greater than zero for bonding molecular orbital. In objective they will ask such type of questions, overlap integral represented by S, which is a positive, that is greater than zero. But in case of antibonding, overlap integral is less than zero. So this is the main difference. And for non-bonding, overlap integral is equal to zero. So in objective such type of questions will be asked. Then next, already in the formation of H2 molecular orbital, which is formed from hydrogen atomic orbitals, then H having electronic configuration 1s1, so here one electron and here left side, right side one electron. When these two atomic orbital combines, we are getting sigma 1s bonding and sigma star, that is a antibonding. So more electron density here, but there is a no electron density, that is a low electron density or zero electron density. So this is the main structure of bonding and antibonding molecular orbitals. सो हियर सपोज ऑलरेडी वी हैव सीन इन लास्ट स्लाइड दैट इज व्हेन एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल ऑफ वन कंबाइंस विद एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल ऑफ अनदर वी आर गेटिंग बॉन्डिंग एंड एंटीबॉन्डिंग मोलिकुलर ऑर्बिटल्स. सो हियर the bonding molecular orbital having lower energy than that of the atomic orbital. Suppose this is the energy, then as compared to atomic orbital energy, this energy is low one, and antibonding molecular orbitals having the higher energy at the positions. Then next we will see what are the conditions for successful overlap. So conditions for successful overlap, there are three conditions. In objective they will ask one of the condition as it is. So first condition is the atomic orbitals should have same or similar energy. Suppose in the formation of homonuclear diatomic molecule, the atomic orbitals are at the same energy level, so extent of overlap is more, consequently energy is released is more, and hence system becomes more stable. That is, 1s combines with 1s, but 1s does not combine with 2s atomic orbital in case of homonuclear diatomic molecule. That is, both are having same energy, but in case of heteronuclear diatomic molecules, due to difference in electronegativity, atomic orbitals lie at different energy level. The most important condition is, smaller the difference in energy, more is the degree of overlap. So as the difference in energy of combining atomic orbitals goes on increasing, then possibility of overlap is less. So in heteronuclear, due to electronegativity difference, both the orbitals lie at different positions, but small difference fruitful overlap, large difference there is a no overlap. So first condition, the atomic orbital should have same or similar energy. Then second condition, the combining atomic orbitals should have same symmetry about the molecular axis. Example, s orbital of one atom overlaps with the s orbital of another successful overlap, or s overlaps with px sigma bonding orbital, because they lie in the same symmetry. But s orbital of one atom does not overlap with py pz orbital, because py pz are pi bonding and s is a sigma bonding, so overlapping is not possible. Similarly, px does not combine with py and d does not combine with s, so these are the some examples which are not possible. That is, s does not combine with py and py does not combine with px, and D does not combine with S. So these are the second condition, that is, combining atomic orbitals should have same symmetry about the molecular axis. And third one, the combining atomic orbitals should be able to overlap appreciably. That is, combining atomic orbitals should have adequate, appropriate and effective overlap, since increase in extent of overlap increases the stability. As stability increases, then when overlap of extent increases, these are the three conditions. Then next we will see what are the different types of overlaps are available. That is, s overlap, s orbital overlap with x, then s overlaps with px, px overlaps with px, and py overlaps with py, or pz overlaps with pz. Then first we will see s overlap. Suppose s orbital of atomic orbital of one compound, and similarly atomic orbital of another OS compound, 1s compound, overlapping takes place, then addition, we are getting bonding in phase combination, more nuclei at the center. But when there is a subtraction out of phase combination, plus minus, so there is a repulsion, there is a no electron density at the center, so here we are getting bonding, here we are getting antibonding. So this is a s overlap. And in case of s px overlap, suppose here when s combines with px sigma bonding orbital, when there is an addition in phase combination takes place plus plus, we are getting sigma bonding, and out of phase combination subtraction plus minus, where there is no electron, these are antibonding. So SPX, we are getting bonding antibonding. Similarly in PX, PX sigma bonding, and addition takes place, in phase combination takes place, and we are getting bonding. But in case of subtraction, that is plus minus combination, out of phase combination there is no electron, so these are the antibonding. And lastly in PY, PY or PZ, PZ overlap, when PY, PY overlaps with each other, then in case of addition there is a lateral overlap takes place between in phase combination, we are getting sigma, here pi bonding, pi PY or pi PZ, pi bonding orbitals, so these are the attraction. But in case of subtraction, out of phase combination plus does not lateral overlaps with minus, so there is a repulsion, there is no electron, so these are the antibonding. So this is the overlap positions or different types of overlaps available in the atomic orbitals. And lastly we will see some difference between sigma and pi molecular orbital. How sigma bond will be formed? That is formed by head on or coaxial overlap in objective, such type of question will be asked. And how pi bond, it is formed by sidewise or lateral overlap. Then in sigma, extent of overlap is more fruitful, but in pi, extent of overlap is comparatively less. Then delocalization of electron density is along with internuclear axis, because it is a head-on collision, then more nuclei at the center. But in case of pi bonding, delocalization of electron density is above and below the internuclear axis, because there is a lateral overlap. And sigma bonds are denoted by sigma and sigma star, but pi bonds are denoted by pi and pi star. Examples of sigma bonding is hydrogen, lithium, HF molecules, but pi bonding forming are nitrogen, oxygen molecules, etc. So this is about the sigma and pi bonding difference. So thank you all of you for listening this.